Hi everybody, this is Katie. Welcome to episode 9 of Botanical Garden Getaway. Today, we're going to be working on the butterfly garden. This is a really cool area of the island as it has a waterfall on one end, the path that kind of loops down and back again, and the area is almost completely down here in this little valley, which is kind of cool. As we get started, we have a little bit of terraforming and construction to do. I know that I want to put a bridge in here, probably not diagonal, we're just going to do a regular bridge, and we'll need an incline, and so I'm putting in some water first so that I know where it's going. I know that the water needs to come outward, but that it's not going to leave the area because it really doesn't have anywhere to go to on the other side, so I want, a little bit of a pond. Probably not a big one, and it is a waterfall, so I imagine it'll do a little bit of a pond here, move under the bridge a little bit, and then a little bit of water on the other side. At least that's what I was thinking. And so I'm trying to create a place on the path here where I can put a bridge. Because it's going to be a straight bridge, all I want to do is get the minimum 3 squares of water put together, so it's a really small bridge. I'm putting the suspension bridge down. I love the way this bridge looks when it's little. It just is precious. And then over here, I'm putting a log staircase in place so that we can get up to the other side. It's important to get those landmarks put together before I finish terraforming. And it's important to finish that type of terraforming before I figure out where the garden space is gonna go, because I would hate to put a garden down and then realize the water needed to come over a little bit and then you're picking things up like crazy. That's how you go mad. So I've learned how to just get some of these types of things down before I really work on the details of decorating in space. So you can see while I'm using 4 wide paths through all of the park, in this particular spot, I felt as if it was going to be a little odd looking if it really was that wide. And so I've let it be a little smaller, just here in a little bit of a spot where I needed it to be tighter so that it fit in the space better. And now I'm expanding that water out so that I'm comfortable with the type of area that it's covering. It's supposed to have a lot of water, and I wanted at least a couple of those cool little jump spots in the middle. I'm putting down some pathing for a display area. I put together a couple custom designs for this butterfly park that are on a simple panel, and these simple panels are meant to be as if they are giving you information about the butterflies, kind of like the type of place you would see in a zoo or even in a garden like this where you would learn, right? The educational panels. And because the Alexandria butterfly is so big, its model is so big, I felt like it was a good choice to be a little bit of a featured model in this area and have put the panels behind it. I like the way that they came out, and they will be available on this particular items if you go to my creator code. They'll be there as well as the other patterns that I've used up until now. I'm using the corral fencing here to just go throughout the area a little bit. I am putting it on that top corner, which might seem weird, but that's because the top of the next area, while it is a different theme, is really visible when you're in this butterfly area, just because of the way that the land layers down into the valley. So I used it up there too. I'm using the beautiful little mum cushions in quite a few areas, and I'm trying to decide where to put everything exactly, and I'm also putting down that dirt again, so I'm identifying the flower patches. There's not going to be a lot of room in this tight little area for trees, so it'll be fairly open. So I'm also considering where a tree will fit. I'm going to need at least a couple down here just so that it continues to look like it's really beautiful and complete. So I've been thinking about that while I put some of the space down, is where can I get a couple trees in place? You'll see here, I'm moving the lights around a little bit. I decided the path was so close together that putting this little lantern on both sides of the path, on both parts of the path, it was gonna be a little bit of overkill. So I just did it on the outside edge. You can see here I'm putting down a little bit of that wheat decoration that we got from the Thanksgiving thing. I know that might seem odd, but I was trying to create some additional layers of texture in spots that were maybe a little unpredictable. And I'm going to be putting down a few just random logs and stools and places for butterflies later. I think this is the first time I ever used those Cosmo shower plants that I just put at the entrance. And I was really excited to see that they had a customization in white. They were really pretty at the entrance there. I didn't expect that to work so well. The deer scare that I put down just then on the other side of the water has a really cool noise to it, which is a big reason why I included it in this area, because I like the sound that it makes. Here I'm taking those butterfly models and I'm scattering them all throughout the area. This was actually fun because I was putting them not just in the area down in the valley, but also including, where possible, butterflies up here on the cliff around the valley, so that it's almost as if you're walking through this path area and the butterflies just surround you. Since there's only room for a couple of trees, you have the opportunity to see more of the butterflies too, which I think works out really well. So at this point, I'm just mixing about the colors here and there a little bit and trying to turn so some are facing different directions, which was really useful in making them look a little more natural. And then again, up here, you can see just kind of tucking them in the cliff. I didn't want to put them so far away that they could be very easy to see in other parts of the island, but here it's nice because I have the extra layer of cliff that is part of why I decided to use the butterfly garden in this spot on my island. It was intentional in that regard because I knew that I would have an extra layer behind so that the butterflies could really go up two tiers and be really dramatic, at least in that effect, which was kind of fun. With all the decorations mostly in place, I went back to collect all of the greenery. This has been a really fun area for the flowers because there are quite a few different flower designs that or flower colors that I'm using here. You can see I have the orange rose, the orange pansy, and the orange cosmo. And then I'm also using the yellow tulips, the yellow pansy, and the yellow mum. So I have really good diversity in texture and color styles. And as I'm putting them down, I had to go out of my way to make the flowers look random in trying to not have as much of a pattern, but mostly just mixed about. So I did pick up some of the extra, these are the white mums that I am also putting in here because I needed a little bit more diversity of flowers to completely be random in some of the areas. So in general, I think it came out well. Let's go do a final look. Here you can see that butterfly with the information panel, a variety of flowers. I moved the bench out from in front of that one and put it over here on my final walkthrough. I feel like that was a really good call so that you could see the flowers better. And I'm just going to walk through these flowers a little bit so you can see some of the decorations up on the cliff and through the area, across the little bitty suspension bridge, and then the big, beautiful flower garden down here. I absolutely love that the butterflies also like being in there with the bright flowers. I hope you guys found something useful here and that you continue creating in this game. Until next time, have the best Animal Crossing day.